Good afternoon.
Good afternoon.
Welcome to St. Rose of Lima Church. If you are able, please stand and please join in singing our gathering hymn, number 853, All People That On Earth Do Dwell. 853.
Thank you.
Forgive us our sins and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Almighty, ever-living God, lead us to a share in the joys of heaven, so that the humble flock may reach where the brave shepherd has gone before. Bless and grace we do in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. Peter, filled with the Holy Spirit, said, "Leaders of the the people and elders. If we are being examined today about a good deed done to a cripple, namely, by what means was he saved, then all of you and all the people of Israel should know that it was in the name of Jesus Christ, the Nazarene, whom you crucified, whom God raised from the dead. In his name, this man stands before you healed. He is the stone rejected by the builders, which has become the cornerstone. There is no salvation through anyone else, nor is there any other name under heaven given to the human race by which we are to be saved. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you. reading from the first letter of St. John. Beloved, see what love the Father has bestowed on us, that we may be called the children of God. Yet so we are. The reason the world does not know us is that it did not know him. Beloved, we are God's children now. What we shall be has not yet been revealed. We do know that when it is revealed, we shall be like him, for we shall see him as he is. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Today is Good Shepherd Sunday, the fourth Sunday of Easter. And for the last 60 years on this day, the Church also observes a World Day of Prayer for Vocations. Do you see the connection between shepherds and vocations? You've got one of those shepherds right behind us here. The Latin word for shepherd is pastor. What is a pastor? In our Catholic Church, a pastor is a priest who is assigned to lead the flock of sheep of a given parish. There are two general types of parishes. There's what we call a personal parish, or sometimes also known as an ethnic or cultural parish, such as a French-Canadian or Lithuanian or Polish parish. There's also a territorial parish. It covers a certain geographic area. Here in Northborough, we have two parishes. They're both territorial parishes. According to census data, there are about 15,000 people in the town of Northborough, and about 40% of those people are Catholic. Now, doing the math, and assuming that for conversation's sake, we're evenly split between the two parishes, that means that Father Juan is responsible for the spiritual care of the souls of 3,000 Catholics in this town. That is a tall order for any pastor. That's where we, the sheep, come into the picture. We have to look at it this way also. Even though there may be 3,000 inhabitants that are Catholic in the territory of our parish, only about 15%, or 500, participate in a regular basis in the faith life of this community by coming to weekly Mass. Those other 2,500, those are among the people that Jesus references in today's Gospel, the sheep who do not belong to the fold, but who also must be led. When I speak of these Catholics, I'm not even speaking about the non-Catholic Christians and the non-Christians who also must be led in our town. They all need to receive the fullness of the good news, the fullness of the Gospel. Each of us, through our baptism, is called to help in this shepherding effort of all of those around us. We are each called to evangelize, to spread the good news. Now, when we come to Mass each week, one of the first things we do is we turn and we welcome one another. If we look around, we realize we all pretty much sit in the same location each week, but there may be people that are still out and about, very healthy people that used to sit near us that don't anymore. Maybe they stopped because of the pandemic. Maybe they stopped before that because of the scandals. Maybe something in the church offended them at some point. Maybe they didn't realize that a sin that they committed can be forgiven by God, that nothing is beyond the mercy of God to forgive and forget. These are people that we likely encounter in our daily lives. They may be relatives, they may be neighbors, friends, acquaintances, co-workers, classmates. We are charged with the responsibility of going out and helping to spread the good news to them. I'm going to give you a challenge. I encourage each of you to try to think back of at least one such person that you think that at some point you might be able to invite to come to Mass with you. That's the way we grow our community, through personal encounter, through personal invitation. Now, some of us may say, well, I don't really have the courage to do that, or, you know, I want to be politically correct. We live in a post-Christian society, and you're going to be really sensitive when you talk about things like politics or religion. We are here because we believe in our Lord Jesus Christ, that he died on that cross, rose from the dead, so that we can be welcomed into his heavenly kingdom. He needs us to be his hands and to be his voice in this effort. So what does he do for us? At this altar, we come each week to celebrate the Eucharist. And through the precious body and sacred blood of our Lord, we are nourished with sacramental grace that will empower us, strengthen us, encourage us to be witnesses of the faith in our words and in our actions with other people. This brings up another issue. In order to celebrate the Eucharist, we need the ministry of priests. We also need the ministry of priests for other sacraments. It's no secret that the number of priests has been on the decline for more than half a century. I am the first man from my home parish, a approaching priesthood in more than 30 years. How often has a man from this parish gone on to become a priest? The issue isn't that God has stopped calling men to the priesthood, or stopped calling women to religious life, or calling men to religious life. It's that in the noise of today's society, men and women may not be hearing the voice. There's too much confusion out there. It could also be that they need a little bit of encouragement. As the people in the pews, you may look around and you may see people, men and women, that you think might have a religious vocation. Don't be afraid to say something to them. Throughout the course of my life, different people, priests, religious sisters, relatives, mentioned to me on occasion to consider the priesthood. But ultimately, it was when several people in my congregation, one-on-one, would make comments to me, that it finally sunk in. If you see something, say something. You don't have to be overly aggressive. Be patient, but be persistent. Everything happens in God's time, not in our time. So whether a man is 26 or 56, as I will be in 2 weeks, it's all part of God's plan, and we are all part of God's plan. If you feel the Holy Spirit stirring you in your heart, take action on it. Our diocese has thrived for nearly 75 years, and for it to continue for another 75, we need all hands on deck, being the hands and voice of our Lord in helping to shepherd his flock.
Let us unite our voices in professing our faith in the Apostles' Creed, as we say, I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary,
suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried, he descended to hell, on the third day he rose again. He ascended to heaven and is seated at the right hand of God, the Father Almighty. From there he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen.
God the Father has sent us the gift of the Good Shepherd who lead us into the ways of holiness. Placing our trust in our Shepherd, we lift up our prayers and intentions.
For the Church, that we may distinguish the voice of God, of the Good Shepherd, from all the other messages that we hear, and faithfully respond to all of Christ's invitations, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the leaders of nations, that God will give them a heart like the Good Shepherd, compassion toward those who are suffering, and wisdom to develop policies that advance the common good. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That those being formed in the religious life or for ordination will one day become holy, selfless leaders. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For Macklin Sullivan, who is being baptized this weekend, may he be brought to the fullness of your peace and glory. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all those preparing for confirmation, that they will be open to the gifts of that the Holy Spirit offers them, and that they will enrich the Church with their talents and energy. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all those who have died, particularly Joseph Wheeler, who died this past week, and especially for the Malazzi family and Mick Bukite, for whom this Mass is being offered. May they be raised up on the last day to live forever. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Heavenly Father, your Son, the Good Shepherd, carries us to your presence and helps us in all our needs. We lift up these intentions to you, knowing in whom we have placed our trust, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
As our gifts are presented in the altar, may it please join in singing our offertory hymn, number 534, Now the Green Lane Rises, 534.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice of your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all this holy church.
Grant, we pray, O Lord, that we may always find delight in these Paschal mysteries, so that the renewal constantly at work within us may be the cause for our unending joy, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord to be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation at all times to acclaim you, Lord. But in this time above all, to love you yet more gloriously, when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. He never ceases to offer himself for us, but defends us and ever pleads our cause before you. He is the sacrificial victim who dies in the morning, the lamb once slain who lives forever. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exalts in your praise, and even the heavenly powers with the angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they sing. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, gave you thanks, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory." The mystery of faith. So, having called us to your table, Lord, confirm us in unity, so that together with Francis, our Pope, and Robert, our Bishop, with all bishops, priests, and deacons, and your entire people, as we walk your ways with faith and hope, we may strive to bring joy and trust into the world. Remember the deceased members of the Mulazi family and Miku Kate, and all our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all the dead whose faith you alone have known. Admit them to rejoice in the light of your face, and in the resurrection give them the fullness of life. Grant also to us, when our earthly pilgrimage is done, that we may come to an eternal dwelling place and live with you forever. There, in communion with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, your spouse, with the Blessed Apostles and Martyrs, with St. Rose of Lima and all the saints, we shall praise and exalt you through Jesus Christ, your Son. Through him and with him and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Deliver
us, Lord, we pray from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory of yours now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, whose center of apostles, peace I give you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, for the reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord to be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
As we come forward to receive the body and blood of Christ, please join in singing our communion hymn, number 914, Lord, who at your first Eucharist, 914.
Look upon your flock, a kind shepherd, and be pleased to shepherd the eternal pastures, the sheep you have redeemed by the precious blood of your Son, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
Please be seated for a moment.
gifted you for a purpose. We know this is true by faith. But have you ever wondered what your gifts are or what you're called to do with them? In a few weeks, in honor of Pentecost, we will be offering a special 4-week workshop in which we're going to explore not only the calling that God has given to us, but also learn how we have been abundantly gifted for the sake of community. In this workshop, we're going to understand what the charisms are. We'll explore 24 of the most common charisms and learn how to discern the charisms which we have each been individually gifted. The goal of this workshop is to bring us to a greater awareness of who we are and who God is calling us to be. It's about knowing in our hearts that we are each deeply loved and abundantly gifted, that we each have a unique purpose in this life to which God is calling us, and that by exercising the gifts that we have been given by God for others, we will find our joy and our meaning. This Spiritual Gifts Workshop will be held on 4 consecutive Tuesdays, beginning May 14th, in the Parish Hall. Each session will be from 6 to 8. A late meal will be available, so there's no need to stop for dinner before you come. If you are interested, sign-ups are in the gathering space. Other announcements. We have sign-ups for lector training, for Eucharistic minister training, for taking the bus to the cathedral to see Deacon Stephen's ordination, and for Pentecost this year, we're looking for people who speak a second language to help us celebrate the diversity of our church by saying the prayers of the faithful in a variety of languages. If you can speak a language other than English and would like to sign up to read one of the prayers, please sign up in the gathering space. Just one person per language. If your language is not written, please do fill it in as other and give us your information. And if someone has signed up on the one language you can speak, sadly mine is only English, feel free to sign up for a different mass and put it in for them. Finally, Corpus Christi will be celebrated June 1st and 2nd, and again, we will be having an overnight adoration. Again, sign-ups are in the gathering space, and we also have them online. And we will again be providing an opportunity to offer votive candles for the Corpus Christi celebration. If you would like to offer a candle for a loved one or a special intention, the suggested donation is $10, and envelopes are, you probably guessed it, in the gathering space. That's it for today. Thank you, and have a great week, everyone.
The Lord is with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you all, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go and announce the gospel of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Have a wonderful evening. Love you all.
Thank you, Father.
As we go forth to share our love and light, please join in our closing hymn, number 6.